Hey, this is Doug Field, CEO of the Institute for Healthcare Consumerism, along with my co-host, Brent Macy, Managing Director. And welcome back to Healthcare Consumerism Radio. To continue the discussion around all the different moving parts of healthcare consumerism, we have joining us the CEO of Interactive Health, in fact, the new CEO of Interactive Health since July, Kathy Kenworthy. Kathy, good morning.
Good morning, Doug. How are you?
I'm doing great. Hey, congratulations on assuming the CEO role earlier this summer.
It's a real privilege. Thank you very much.
Give our audience a little background on Interactive Health, and then let's talk about wellness and healthcare consumerism.
Sure. Interactive Health is a pioneer in providing preventative care to employees on behalf of employer groups. We have been in the business for many decades. I know last year you all had a chance to talk with Joe O'Brien on this program, and I know how much he enjoyed that, our former CEO. And you know, it's a space we're very passionate about. We take a very clinically rigorous and fairly specific approach and are thrilled with the kind of impact that we have on employees across the country.
And then earlier this year, you acquired Health Solutions, did you not, Charlie, and his group?
That's correct, yeah. We really are the largest independent provider of wellness programs, and we offer really now the full spectrum of almost every concept in the wellness arena. We continue to innovate and build upon that, but we're very pleased about the marriage with Health Solutions. We have some really common cultural underpinnings in terms of an employee base that's passionate about employee health, and so we're having a great time with that.
Kathy, this is Brent. There's and congratulations on becoming the CEO.
Thank you, Brent.
There's a lot of wellness players out there in the space. What really makes you guys different from the other players in the market?
Thanks. Yeah, it's terrific that wellness is now something that I think has become much more commonplace in terms of employer groups really thinking through what kind of wellness strategy makes sense for their employee group. So we welcome lots of participants in the market, but what makes us different is really the comprehensiveness of our program. We really intentionally knit together every element of our program to be able to accomplish a very specific goal, which is changing, in truth, the individual health outcomes, and we've done a lot of work on the data that supports that claim, and I'd love to share more of that with you. Our programs are customized. We really pride ourselves in working very closely with employer groups to tailor something that's going to fit very carefully into their culture and what's important within the culture, and we know that's an important key. We have a lot of experience in doing this. We've been doing this for several decades across the entire company, and so that experience allows us to draw upon a lot of interesting options in terms of how to design those programs. We work with over 2,000 clients from small little companies you may have heard of like General Motors to hundreds of small and mid-sized businesses that we're very proud to work with. And so we're able to draw upon that experience to really do the first two things that I said, which is comprehensive, customized, and programs that really drive results.
Yeah, you know, Kathy, I like what you talk about, some of your initiatives that, you know, you work with your employers to put wellness programs in place in concert with helping them create better consumers of health and healthcare, something we talk about a lot. And I really like that philosophy because I think that is the end game that we're all trying to do in this space, you know, create better consumers of health and healthcare.
Correct. Yeah, and it's really interesting as I've had a chance to read up a little bit on your organization and the work that you do to promote the innovation within the space around consumerism. And I do think, and I think our company feels very strongly, that in the end, it's all of us as individuals taking accountability and taking real pride in being preventative, real pride in being proactive with regard to living a long and happy and healthy life, and that takes like many other things in life, when we have a goal, we're able to work towards that goal and make sure that we're knowledgeable, targeted, specific interactions, and that's what we really work hard with employees to do. You know, consumerism has become obviously a significant word and trend and topic within healthcare, and you know, we really think there's a lot of lessons from other walks of life that can be applied to helping all of us be consumers about our healthcare.
You know, Kathy, we talk about wellness, and And we can't have that discussion without also talking about the chronic care parts of our population. And if we don't really help them manage that, I think you guys are doing some unique things around diabetes and pre-diabetes programs. Can you talk a little bit about that, please?
I'd love to. I mean, exactly to your point, it's particularly important that those individuals who find themselves either at risk for or actually in process of managing a chronic condition to take particular attention to being preventative and proactive in terms of their care. We know from our work that somebody who is at risk of prediabetes has tremendous opportunity to avert the progression to diabetes, which obviously once you reach that stage, you're going to be there for life. So there's a huge premium in terms of helping draw people back from that brink. We know from the work that we do that within 1 year of identifying somebody who is pre-diabetic, and by the way, many people don't have any understanding of their risk for pre-diabetes in the employee populations that we work with. We do a lot of specialized testing to be able to uniquely identify pre-diabetics through a combination of glucose, A1C, health evaluation, and other information that we utilize. We find within 1 year of working with individuals who are pre-diabetic, 43% of them move all the way back to a healthy state. Wow. That's creating enormous opportunity for that individual in terms of, continuing to lead a healthy life and having averted that potential progression to diabetes. We also know that, say, as employer groups, significant money, the cost of care for a pre-diabetic might be $500, the cost of care for somebody who is, in an advanced stage of diabetes can run $20,000, if not more. And then to tie in the consumerism piece, obviously that could create a significant financial burden for the individual. So we're very passionate about our work with diabetes. At the other end of the spectrum, we will encounter individuals who are at significant progression of diabetes, maybe in a really panic out of control stage, and still unaware many times. And so we've had dramatic progress we've been able to make with those individuals. We'll see 70 to 80% of those individuals in the course of a year moving all the way back into a control status with their diabetes. We'll see over a 100-point drop in glucose, over a 2-point drop in A1C values, and things that are very significant in terms of the clinical remediation of that situation. So we take a lot of pride in our work overall, but we have maybe a special place in our heart for those individuals who are facing prediabetes or diabetes. Mm-hmm. Obviously, it's something close to an epidemic in this country, and it's something that's very, very important to be attentive to.
Now, Kathy, and I'm assuming that engagement is a very big role in all of this. Kind of talk a little bit about engagement and how you guys, one, get someone engaged, but then keep them engaged in these programs.
Sure. Engagement, and I know many speakers in your program have talked about the importance of balancing communication and incentive design, and we believe strongly in both elements of that. Having the right communication that helps people feel like it's attainable to be engaged, communication that doesn't provoke anxiety but provokes the sense of empowerment and a sense of I can do this, making it safe for people to engage. We think all those elements are very important from a communication and cultural alignment. Incentives matter, and we work very hard with our employer groups to make sure that there are incentives, usually a carrot, maybe some stick, but hopefully a good balance of those incentives that will get people's attention and get them involved. But then to your point, the real trick is to keep somebody engaged and to do that year-round, and our programming is very effective at doing that. We work with people very carefully early to know their numbers, to make sure that that's a huge part of being an empowered consumer, know where you stand. We offer coaching outreach to the populations that most need it. We find 2 to 3% of the population, our real agenda is from a coaching vantage point to help that individual connect to formal care in the medical system. They may have significant issues that are causing real medical risk, whether that be cancer possible, unfortunately, or significant progression of various kidney, liver, other kinds of diseases. And so we don't diagnose, but we really work hard with that individual to connect them into the appropriate element of medical care. We have significant portions of the population, generally 30 to 35% of the population, who have something else going on with regard to risk, maybe around the prediabetes that I mentioned, metabolic syndrome, things of that sort. Mm-hmm. And many of those conditions can be averted through help in terms of nutrition, fitness, medication, smoking cessation, things of that sort. So we'll work across a broad continuum to help those individuals. There's many individuals that are healthy, and the goal is to stay healthy. And so we have a lot of programming around challenges and other kinds of things that can be helpful to that. One other quick element I wanted to mention is that we have a very highly trafficked website, and close to 500,000 people will be active users of our website this year. They'll spend over 10 minutes per visit, which I think is very, very significant in terms of web activity. And there's a multitude of resources, interactive calculations, interactive tools that help people personalize and reach for the help that they may need and be able to take further action based on that. So a year-round approach we know is, in the end, the thing that will drive outcomes and help make the changes that I'm talking about.
Kathy, we got about a minute or two left on this program, and tell our audience, where do you see the wellness market, over the next five to six years moving, and then let them know how they can get a hold of you guys for more information on your services.
Sure. Well, let's start just by saying, come visit us at interactivehealthinc.com. We have lots of good information on client testimonials and other resources that can be very informative. So come see us there right away. And over the next 5 or 6 years, I mean, it's a very exciting time in our industry. I think we have really only scratched the surface of the kind of impact that preventative care can have on employees and employer groups. We see really these programs becoming mainstream. And as employers work more and more towards really trying to drive towards accomplishing individual health outcomes, individual health change, and being very measured and specific in terms of being able to see those outcomes, we know that programs like ours have a lot of momentum, and so we look forward to continuing to play in that market.
Well, Kathy, we really appreciate having you on the program today, and to everyone who's out there, wellness is a big piece of everything that we do, and we'll be covered at IHC Forum West coming up November 10th through 12th, and we really appreciate your sponsorship at our May event that we had, Kathy, so thank you very much for that. And again, Interactive Health, and you have some very good products and solutions, so go visit Kathy and her team, and to everybody else, stay tuned for the next segment of Healthcare Consumerism Radio.